Hello, Gundam fans. This is Prime92, and today I'll be looking at the 1144 High Grade 105 Slaughter Dagger from the Gundam Stargazer OVA. So it's essentially, at least the mobile suit itself, is the 105 dagger with the gun barrel that we got earlier in the line. And I guess a more military color scheme, where the original was like blue. Well, it was a Gundam colors, pretty much, minus the yellow. I don't think it had yellow. Oh, this is... I boxed away my old one. I wish I didn't, because I'd like to compare it here, but I don't know where it is. But yeah, essentially the same thing. I do like the helmet. It is different from the normal dagger that we got from C, like the mass production one. And it does have a few stickers. You got the metallic forehead camera, the eyes, which it is a visor sticker, but it would normally, nowadays, it would be an actual clear piece. Yeah, it looks okay. You got the shoulder triangles, and you got the little triangles on the chest, and the same on the knees, and then you got some black, and here on the legs as well. So, yeah, I mean, it's not a whole bunch, but it does help give it some color. And I do like the fact that it has a two-colored foot. I think the original one was red and white, I want to say. But I definitely like the charcoal and burgundy here. This has some nice detailing on the shoulders. Got some thrusters there. On the calf. Yeah, it does look good. A lot of seam lines all over. The arms, all the way down the leg, shoulders, right on the chest, the head. The feet are good, mostly because they have the two-tone color here, so it would be... But, you know, that, I guess they tried to fix it. And they do have the... I think the original had, must have had it, too. But I guess these are the feet falcons, which it used... there was, like, a in the one scene, a bunch of them stood there. They just, like, annihilated a settlement of people. Just murdered them with their feet. So, yeah. It is a neat mobile suit. I do like it in either color. So, even though it came out in the Stargazer line, it was an older release, so nothing amazing in terms of articulation. You got a ball jointed head. You got the swivel at the shoulder, which is weird because I didn't know this before. I didn't realize how it's really angled up high. It's different. I guess it just gives them a little, like, the shoulder higher up. It looks okay. And it does rotate. Although you see, it starts to go in and bump against the chest. Should be okay, though. And the shoulder armor does get out of the way, so you don't go that far out. Rotate below the shoulder. One joint of the elbow. Ball joint of wrist. Swivel at the waist. Not too much. Front skirts are together. Side skirts are pegged, but they don't move a whole bunch. The legs can go forward. Not very far. Back more. Out some. There's a little bit of give in the ball joint at the thigh. You do have a double jointed knee, but a little over 90. The foot armor is pegged onto the leg, or the ankle armor, I should say. The ankle itself is hinged at the top, and then you have a ball jointed foot, which is very free because of the space between the leg armor and the ankle. So that's pretty good, actually. Probably the most articulate part of the entire kit. And because of that, you can get a decent stance with the model, but like everything else is kind of hindered. But you can do some okay posing. So on the kit, you have some beam saber handles, which are just pegged in, much like with the Strike Freedom. And you have a set of clear yellow beams, which I can't think of any... seed kits that had yellow beams. I'm sure there are, I just can't think of. And it does go into the hand. Which is fine. It goes right up to the hilt, but it's fine. A little extra peg does kind of help if you rotate a little bit. It does rest against the, well, not quite the thumb, but close to it. So they're fine. And then you have the dagger shield, which is a two-tone color, gray. And it does kind of clip around the arm, right around the molding here. So it holds well enough. It's not super hard to get it off. And it will rotate. Yeah, that looks okay. And then we have the beam rifle. Which is, once again, it's unique for the, for the seed line. Not sure what that peg is for. I don't remember it pegging. I think I had the same one with the other version. But there's nowhere that I know of to peg this on for storage. So, I don't know. Was it with another kit that I never got or don't remember? It's possible. And it does fit into the hand and it is a little loose. However, all you really have to do to fix that is push the trigger or the handle down so the trigger is inside the hand. And now it says it's secure. Whether it's supposed to be like that, it will wear off that trigger, I don't know. But for now, it is nice and solid. And then finally, it comes with the Aile pack. And I almost forgot, actually I did forget. You also get the numbered stickers with the kit. 105, 6, 7, 8, 9. So yeah, just wanted to mention that. But yeah, this is the old Aile pack in this new color. Pretty sure this part is the same color, I think. If not, it's very close. But then the red is all the gray. Still have the stickers here, the yellow ones on the thrusters here, and then the stickers on the wings. Like, even the newer Aile Strike had the stickers on the wings. They just couldn't figure that out for a high raid. And these are hinged, so they can move. And you also get extra beam sabers on the backpack. And these beams will work, so, I mean, you can use them. Actually, a little tighter fit, but it still works. So, yeah, you, for some reason, I don't know, have lost these, you can still have some. Yeah, it just pegs into the polycap in the back. And there we have it. The solder dagger with the L-tack. It is a little back heavy now, but it's not too hard to adjust them. And the pack really doesn't affect articulation. So yeah, the accessories are good. A lot of them are from the original 105 dagger with gun barrel. And I would complain about the old pack, but the thing is, that's what it was back then. But for some reason, they wouldn't think they were stubby wings. I guess I could still complain because they were stubby back then. I knew they were. But you know what? It's all right. It's not too bad. So I decided to go by the instruction manual and compare it to the one that was next on the list, and that is the Blue Duel. And they're about the same height. Seed kits didn't vary too much. And then, why not show it next to a kit that has the modern Aile pack, the Revive Strike with the Perfect Pack. Check out that wingspan. That's quite... I really need to try and find... I looked, I couldn't find them. I need to find the other Aile pack from the Strike Rouge. I will have to paint it because it's, pink. I think it's pink? Actually, I think it's red. I think it's still the same color. I think. I could be wrong. But that's, quite the difference. Pretty much twice the length, I'd say. And the thickness. Giggity. So, that is the high-grade Slaughter Dagger. It's still good. This was one of my favorite kits from, back then. With the gun barrel. Yeah, it's a good-looking design. I like it more than the standard ones we saw on the show. And it's nice to have the extra Aile pack. So, that is about it, and I'll see you in the next review.